But without further ado, I'll give the controller one more attempt. Nah, it don't want to work tonight. Not a problem. All right, without further ado. Summit C, here we come. Oh boy. Alright, edge boost in up there. Oh my dear god. Have you seen this? I'm guessing you have. And if I don't edge boost, I don't stand a chance. Pretty much. Alright. Okay, let's get the dash back. What's going on there, Dr. K? How you doing tonight, my man? PS4 controller is what I've been using throughout. Nice. Food time. Always a good time of the day. I don't think I'd be able to play this on a keyboard, to be honest. I've always been more of a controller kind of guy, so... That's how I look at it, my man. I was too close underneath. At least we get to listen to this epic, epic, epic Summit remix. I need to dash. I'm doing it right. I've been doing it right. I just need to do a secondary dash. Maybe. I need the edge boost. I can't just jump. There we go. Oh my goodness, get on that, please, Madeline, thank you. Ooh. Maybe I don't edge boost, maybe I just need to use the upwards wind there instead. Why am I doing a diagonal? I don't understand. Need to get closer on the ledge to... Missed the freaking stamina. Got an edge boost. Okay. I gotta do it in one though, because I need to keep my boost for that second bit. Which is crazy. Missed the gym there. It's pretty unforgiving. You have to chain together the edge boost or else you're back to the beginning. And that one there, I don't seem to be able to. I'm edge boosting too quickly, it seems, and I'm not getting the right amount of height. I double dashed. How am I supposed to let's see how I'm meant to get that one. Because I need to double dash to get up there. I are confused. How did I grab onto that ledge with the spikes? I don't understand. Alright, I need to double edge boost. That's what I need to do. So simple. Well, I didn't think about that before. Also, I've just realised I haven't got got my speedrun clock on because I took my screenshot and didn't put it back on. There we go. I can feel myself grimacing. Oh dear. There's rumours my wife said about me pulling faces when I game are true. No! Alright. Can't get like a consistency on like the height on the edge boost for some reason. I don't know why. It's quite annoying. That's better. Guess I'd be better to like try and do it all in one fluid motion. I guess that would probably, it's gonna give me more momentum, right? I guess. Off it. Had it. That proved I didn't need to do it in one fluid motion either, which was good. I can pause, just need to give myself like a little bit more height. When that spam account plays Portal with your face as their profile picture. Oh, I can't believe Conclan still uses that. Yeah, it's a photo of me that's been stretched out and God knows what else has happened to it. I'd hate to imagine. Classic Death Wish. You hear about the poor guy's YouTube channel? YouTube nuked his channel. For no apparent reason whatsoever. Yeah, it's dude didn't even have like any copyright strikes or anything, they just like removed his channel. Not good. Come on. Yeah, I don't know what YouTube's playing at the minute. YouTube is, in my opinion, although I'm still very active on YouTube, tends to be holding a gun against his head a lot of the time. Playing a very dangerous game. Grab the ledge, and then I didn't react in time to get in the freaking gem. Almost, yeah, almost. Expect weird noises from here on out. Dashes. But yeah, I am getting more consistent. That's a good thing. First screen done. All right. So into a diagonal up. Oh, you are kidding. I see what I need to do. That is evil. I need to dash into that button, but also get the spring as it falls. Jeez. Ugh. Almost. I think we've got this screen. I think We've got the screen. All right. Are you looking at this? Don't you cover them eyes up. You're looking at this. If I've got to look at this, you've got to look at this. This is where I need to be, like, on point with inputs. Directional inputs, especially. I think I've got to do a diagonal right to get that one there, because else I've not got enough of an angle. Yeah, I've not got enough of an angle else to get round to that spring. Oh my geez. I'm gonna do something stupid like that. Mm-hmm. I'd like to think that once I get past like the spring area, the bit with the gems will actually be a bit easier. Way too low for the spikes there. Alright, I need to be quicker on my dash there. That's what's causing me the issue there. It's annoying that I'm not getting consistency off this first spring, though. I can't seem to get the consistent height to get over that first gap. I can't do a diagonal, it's got to be a straight up. Kind of hit the top of the stream versus hit in the middle. Would it keep some of the height for you? I don't know. Might do. That might actually be a good shout, Dr. K. Yeah, that seems to be it. Thank you very much. Dr. K coming in with a pro Celeste strats. Gave up holding right. Things happened. There was a rose. Oh my god. Things just happened. Holy jeez. I think we got over halfway through the spring section as well, so that was quite positive. But now I may have, having that little break now, may have just like, might take me a few attempts just to get back into the swing of this now. Knows. Man, this game makes my nose so itchy. I don't know what it is. I think it's that thing where any game you've got to like really concentrate and you can't really take your hands off the controller. Your body just instantly reacts to try and put you off. Your body works against you, man. evil thing in your body. I'll have to go back and let's go back and clip that moment, man. That was just absolutely crazy. It's always my nose as well. I don't know why. Close. I think that was actually close to getting out of the spring section. Yeah, that was it. Alright, we're nearly there. We're getting good, guys. Save that. Almost recovered that. I was really low and I managed to get a diagonal dash, which was actually gonna save me, but I wasn't really prepared for the save. I think I'd already accepted the failure at that point. Summit is a nice looking area. This and Reflection, the previous level. Lots of like blues and greens and stuff. It's quite a nice looking area, but no, Summit is a very nice area indeed. Spring there, that last spring I hit. Mm-hmm. Now I can't get over this spikes here. Why can't I go over this gap now? Then when you do get over it, you mess your inputs up. Of course. I wonder if I'm just dashing too early on the second dash. Yeah, I think that's what it is. Ooh, so close. There is just no respite though on this level. There's nowhere where you could just like stop and take a breather for a moment. It's just one constant like go, 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 go. Which is mad. Alright, I'm starting to feel really confident about this first area, and now it's all gone to pot. Hi, Nock. way too low on that spring. I was lucky I got that. I wasn't ready to hit that. I've hit that usual sort of slump where I start to build consistency and then I can't get past the first area and I lose everything. It's a common occurrence on these seasides. It drives me crazy. Get a drink. 2 seconds, guys. And we're back. This level is definitely going to come down to a matter of pixels, I think. Pixels are literally the difference between life and death. Excuse me. No, I can't get past here. Yeah, very small error margin, but then all part of the fun, indeed. This late stage in the game, though, to be expected. I'm hitting that slump again now where I've lost my consistency. I appreciate the encouragement. The first real major hurdle, though, is, I consider, is this bit, going from that spring to that spring, the one on the left to the one in the middle, getting past that little kink in the middle there, just because you've got to do that free falling, is the first bit, and then getting to here is all about being far enough to the left to dash so that when you start free falling, you're not just going to drop into that little alcove there, you're going to drop down so you can then do it again. Well, see, then you need to land on the cloud, bounce out, spring across, edge boost up to there, grab the gem, hit the cloud but don't bounce off it, then dash across, dash up, off the spring, and then that's where the fun starts. That section is not too bad. There's not many places there. I'm not sat here going, well, I don't know how to get there. I can see exactly how I need to get there. The problem is just all pulling off in one complete run. That's the part. But as we found with Temple last night, once you get to the gem sections, that was actually the easiest part. So I'm hoping, but once I can get to the gem section again here, it's going to be pretty easy. Literally on Temple last night, when I got to the gem section, I did it within two attempts. Second attempt, I did it. And the problem here is that the gem section is so freaking far away. There's the spring. The fact that I just pulled a beer out the garage as well. Probably not the best choice of beverage for this sort of endeavor. I probably should have gone for water. Yeah, that's that bit there is the first real tricky section. I should be able to consistently get to that point. Wow, I think I've died there before. That was like touch and go whether or not I hit that spring there. Oh, no, I didn't dash up. Alright, I'm gonna try. Try that screen shake. Can't get over this bit now. There we go. Didn't dash up again. So it's really quite frustrating about my controller overlay not working, so I can't look back to actually see what. I can't look back. Oh, it's not working. But yeah, I can't look back to see what inputs I made, which is very annoying. Back myself into, I doubted myself. I was lined up perfectly. All it would have taken was another dash. And now, of course, now I've done that, and I was starting to get consistent, I start messing up on the first bit. because why not? Diagonal. Will you stop itching, body? Jeez. Thumb keeps slipping. Pulled left too much. I need to turn the webcam off for now, so I'm not really talking that much, so yeah, I will talk to someone who does talk and chat. Playing. Rogue Legacy. I actually won that in a giveaway on a stream this week. Although, after I won it, I found out I'd already got it on PS4, so I actually gave it back to the person so they could re-give it away. But yeah, I've got it on PS4 and not actually played it. Isn't it it's one of those like randomized games, isn't it? Like every, it's levels are randomly generated is what I'm trying to say. I'm sorry, I can't get the words out. About as much as I know about it though, so. Platforming is a part of it as well. Okay. Maybe I'll, I need to try it out. I'm actually thinking though, after Celeste, I'm going to mix it up a bit because we've done pretty much two hardcore platformers back to back on the channel, so I may look at playing an RPG next on the channel. And there'll be a toss up between, I think, Legend of Zelda Link to the Past or Final Fantasy VIII. So I'll decide later on. My first Zelda game was like Link's Awakening on the Game Boy way back when. I can't really understand why I never got Link to the Past for my Super Nintendo. So I never played that, and Final Fantasy VIII, I had it, I never finished it. So I got to disc 4 and I was like so underleveled, I just couldn't defeat the bosses on disc 4. So I do own it on Steam now, so I'd like to go back and actually try and finish it. I played Link's Awakening on the Game Boy, and then I didn't play another one until Ocarina of Time. Played Majora's Mask, never finished it, which is one of my biggest regrets. Um, Oh, boys. That was looking good. All right, so yeah. I had Majora's Mask when it came out, and never finished it. Unfortunately, and then I sold my N64. I did try and start playing it again on an emulator on my channel about 5-6 years ago, but then I had to kind of like move my PC at the time, so I had to make way working from home. I had to move out of my home to work at my mother-in-law's because we was expecting our second child and needed the office for a nursery, so and then I kind of didn't have the time to kind of play Majora's Mask anymore, which was a bit of a shame. I never really went back to it. I had Twilight Princess on the Wii, and my wife had a DS, and I think I played Phantom Hourglass, and there was another one I think on the DS I played, and then I've played Breath of the Wild as well on my son's Switch. Yeah, wow. All right, let's try and knuckle down a bit more. That was a pretty awesome run. We almost got to the gems. We almost got there. Things are looking up. It's very different. I didn't like it for a start, actually, I'll be honest, because it's so different to any other Zelda game. It's more like a traditional RPG where you kind of like you buy things and you don't have sort of like permanent weapons. Your weapons are what I call kind of consumables. So if you think back to, I can't remember about Majora's Mask, but like Ocarina of Time, you had things like the Deku sticks and things that would break. So a lot of the weapons are like that, and if the weapons don't break, they kind of like have a cooldown, so you can only use them for a certain amount of time, and then you have to let them recharge. And I was really kind of torn about it for a start when I first started playing it, but I think the more I played it, the more I actually kind of enjoyed it and fell in love with the game. So yeah, it's a very cool game. Although I've completed it, I need to go back and like finish off side quests and things. I just think because I'm so used to like playing Zelda games where you have weapons that kind of last and don't break and stuff. That was like the biggest thing that I kind of struggled with in the early game, but that's it. We soon got around it. And yeah. I would say the dungeons are a bit samey though, as well. Dungeons could have done with being a bit different. You pretty much do exactly the same thing in all the dungeons, which can get a bit repetitive. Second pink cloud. That pink cloud that I need to work on. That's where my run ends at the minute. Oh, didn't expect to get so much height off there. Seems to have a bit of a better strategy on there now. I seem to be kind of like hugging the right wall a little bit more. It seems to be... Oh, I don't want to jinx it. Pressing right too early there on them two vertical dashes here. Clearing this first gap. Come on, Nock. That's square one. Stop trolling me! Stop making me itch. What's going on, K7? When I can get through it, I'm very, very close. When I can get a good run, I can get all the way to this cloud here, and that's where it falls apart. And I think if I can get into here, I think we're golden. So yeah, I haven't managed to get on through this gap here off this cloud, but when I can put a run together, we're getting there. But don't worry about dashing off yesterday, my man. It's all good. Things come up. I see that you finished your map as well. I have added to my map request queue. wasn't quite far enough over to the left. It's called maybe K7, or just drop the name of the map in the chat. Feel free to link it for Dr. K as well. K7. We got through the gap that time as well. I don't think I just didn't have enough height though to carry that through. Is that all the way to go? Huh. What, you went? So you went what? Did you go left or right of these spikes? I guess you went like round the right. Like through this gap here. And then do two dashes. Two dashes to get onto the... Alright. You should have seen the first time I did this K7. The first time I got like anywhere far, I was just like, it was completely utterly random, and I was just like pushing in random inputs. And I don't know how I got quite as far. It was quite impressive at the time. I don't know how it happened. I was just like randomly pushing inputs. Had no idea where I was going, but I was getting through it. I need to get up to the top though without using a dash on that cloud, don't I? Right, that's gonna take some. Trying to practice my movement a little bit for that cloud, but yeah, I struggle a little bit with the first screen because like it's literally edge boost after edge boost after edge boost. Second screen, literally three, possibly four attempts, I think, and we was done on that one, and then we've been on here ever since. So, yeah, DLC coming soon, my man. Not gonna be in the Celeste though, because once I've done Seasides, I want to start working on my any percent run. I already have a marker on the board, so there's a lot of improvement needed there. I'm in like the bottom. I think I'm in like the bottom 20. But yeah, plus we've got the DLC coming soon as well, so that'd be quite interesting. Sloppy. The three sips of beer are kicking in. fallen into that rut again though, where I'm losing my consistency. There we go. Don't dash quickly enough. Yeah, I wanted a drink a little while ago. Foolishly, I went to the fridge in the garage and got myself a beer out. And then I said, Dr. K, I said, well, it's probably not the best choice of beverage when I'm trying to do something like this, which requires precision. But, hey. It's all good. Pixels. Oh! Well. That was always going to happen. Unfortunate. Why did I bounce off that cloud? Dash too early. Move to the right. I don't know how to get more height on that cloud. Not just that, but I don't know also how to turn quick enough around the spikes. Oh wow. I did not, Eddie. Let me add that to my bookmarks bar. Definitely one for the books. What's going on though, Eddie? Welcome on stream, buddy. Obviously, it's not, has nothing to do with Port Ponky. I jump off there again. Okay. I know it's going to happen because I didn't hit the spring when I normally hit it, and it kind of threw off my momentum. It's crazy how just like a little subtle change in the way you like move through the level totally throws you off. Don't know how I meant to get around there. Anybody got any tips? Any suggestions how I could, like, get around there a little bit better? Thanks, Eddie. I do miss your hints. Why couldn't they made like a white cloud though? Like, seriously. No, I tell you what it is. I was just really concentrating hard. And when I concentrate hard, I tend not to speak and I tend to pull lots of faces. So I kind of just turned off the webcam just to like save me myself the embarrassment and you the horror of me grimacing and pulling faces. I'm certainly not drunk, that's for sure. Are you one of these people that does this, where you'd like turning left and right with the controller? All the kids used to do that in the 90s. So I do this. So I have that problem because I can't play racing games unless I'm using a wheel. And because I'm using a wheel, my whole body moves anyway, so I have an excuse. Far enough to the right there. Alright, no worries, buddy. I will catch you later. Need for Speed Underground 2, man, was the best. The first one wasn't bad, actually. They were both alright, 1 and 2. I remember spending a lot of time on them ones in my youth. I don't think I've actually played any since Underground 2. I'm more of a sort of simulation kind of racer. So I'll play like the F1 games and things like that. Gran Turismo Sport. More than like an arcade kind of racer. Oh, I like Burnout. Burnout Paradise was good. I remember the original Burnouts, actually, on the older PlayStations. So yeah, they were quite fun. I don't know if I'm showing my age here, but does anybody remember Stuntman as well? Remember that game? I've got 8 years on UK7. I was 34 the other week. Stuntman. He was basically like a stuntman. He was a car driver. He had to like go through various movies and various vehicles and do various kind of like things and chases and stuff. It was quite a cool game. There we go. Look, we've got some stats there. Hit this edge boost now. Alright, I'm going to quickly the run's coming together though now. I mean, especially you'll notice more as well, Dr. K, that from where we were not so long ago to now, we've made leaps and bounds. I just want to see how this cloud thing. Oh wow, you're going over. Okay, so pause. He dashed straight up. It goes round. That's interesting. Don't need to do the edge boost, possibly. Okay, so it goes round, dashes up, and then does that. Okay. Sweaty hand syndrome. That's an older, but they've patched it. They've patched it. Yeah, look, they've patched it. You can't go over it. You have to do the edge boost now. When was that video then? Oh, it's over a year old. So, man, this guy, he got through the seasides pretty early. It's only like about a month after the game came out, so. Need to do the edge boost, please. Wasn't expecting to hit the spring there. Dashed a bit too early, I think, now on the upwards diagonal. Just hit that spring. Why can't I hit this edge boost now? I was hitting no problem before. Off the cloud. There. Wasn't far enough right there. Didn't dash up there. I think we all know what happened there. jump way too quickly off the cloud. Boys. I'm that focused on my movement and Madeline, what Madeline's doing, and I can't even see that bit of spike that I keep hitting myself on that right hand wall. The background is just kind of like all blurring into nothing for me at the minute. Such is how much I'm concentrating actually on Madeline herself. Feels all like snotty. It's hard to describe. Doesn't feel clear when I look out of it. It's probably the best thing to say. Don't know what's going on with it. That's some height on there. Gee, I don't think I've ever been that high before. Excuse me. This edge boost is killing me now. Spring. I don't know on that when I want to get over that bit. What if I need to? I'm doing a right dash. I don't even do a night and upwards right dash. I don't seem to be able to clear that first like lip. The edge boost again. How did I not get across there? Ah, I didn't dash straight up. My audio for a second there. I had dashed my diagonal too early there, so I was late with the upwards dash. Wow, I got across with that. That's interesting. I don't normally get across there. I'm back onto that spring with a just a normal left dash. Sorry, a right dash. I have to do a diagonal up, but that time I did manage to do it. Interesting. I think that's really harsh. I could have put that like so that it was in within like grabbing distance for if you, there's no like backup. Could have been like nice about it, giving me like the backup to put the gem within reach if I grab onto that and jump off, but. Suppose at this stage of the game, they're trying to encourage those advanced techniques, so edge boost or riot. So frustrating though when you get that far. Getting close enough to the right wall now. Think of the sense of achievement though, Dr. K. Think of the sense of achievement and how proud of yourself you'll be. More frustrated in the fact that I was hitting the edge boosts pretty well and now I can't hit them at all. That edge boost wasn't giving me any problem earlier on in the run and now I can't hit it more than once in 10 attempts. Oh well. It's the way the cookie crumbles. Just need to get better. That's frustrating. Losing the cloud so cheaply like that. So that'll be another 10 attempts before I can do another edge boost and get across there. There, I gave myself more airtime and it just completely threw me off. I was delaying hitting the upwards diagonal, but I was in totally the wrong position then for the downward section. The itchies are coming back. I honestly thought there'd be like a checkpoint of some description in this, like there was in Reflection Seaside, like kind of had a like midway point checkpoint. I kind of expected to see something like that on Summit, but hey, I guess that would be making it too easy, right? All out of sorts there. Forgetting to pause on that cloud, which makes it kind of go away instantly. It's my problem at the minute. try my best. I think what I'll do is I'll go and get the bottle of champagne that's on ice in my fridge, and I'll just do a kind of like a Grand Prix style I just won the race kind of celebration. No, don't harm it to that. I don't want to wreck all my computer equipment. Would not be advisable. I missed the spring on the way up. I caught it on the way down, but it just gave me such a different dynamic. It's such a minor thing. But because it's not the way I've learned to do the level, it just completely throws me out. It shouldn't be such a big thing. Why'd I do two quick dashes there? I certainly see what your previous comment, I think it was last night, K7, was about. I think you made a comment in regards to there's a lot of edge boosting to come. Especially at the start of this level, the first room in this level, man, jeez. That was an edge-boosting frenzy. If I'm looking forward to core, I'm gonna get through something first, but depends what mechanics are in core. Straight up with core, I don't mind the horizontal screens. It's the vertical screens I'm not really a fan of in core. So if there's the vertical climbing screens on core seaside, then I may not have much fun with that. Oh, they're vertical? Excellent. Straight up again. I wonder if I could save that if I don't dash straight up. I wonder if I can like get back down and hit the cloud for another attempt. Calling Dr. Keklan. Dr. Keklan, do you come in over? The map from K7 has been updated. I repeat, the map from K7 has been updated. This has been a public knock announcement for Dr. Keklan. Have a nice day. Yeah, I think I wouldn't worry too much about Dr. Keklan. He is quite an experienced portal player. What was that? Miss the spring. Say, as frustrating as that edge boost is, I have to say, when this spring section feels so good when you like just get through it, like bouncing off old springs, jumping over everything. There's something about it that just feels so nice to do. Dashing up too early. I did two quick dashes there to the side. Why did I double dash? Mine went totally blank there. That's what I am doing, K7, I believe. I'm doing an upwards and then an upwards right. So, misunderstanding what you're telling me, that is what I'm doing, K7. No, I take the cloud, and then I do an up dash to give me the height over the top of the spikes. And then I do an upright dash to A, take me over, but also give me the clearance towards the spring. Don't worry, it's all good. You're all good, man. It's all good. Left came too early. That's close. Fat-fingered that. That was the best I've ever got over that cloud as well. Makes me sad. I really think I've got it into a habit that I need to pull Madeline back to the left to get through there. But I think I've got enough without doing it. I need to try and stop doing that left pull back because it's costing me. Then I did a right. Oh, jeez. It's like my finger's like, no, you're not going to go left. I've got to press something. Let's press right. It screws me over the other direction. That's the next issue, is like finding the right place to dash. Alright, I do need to adjust to the left. So I hit spikes there. I knew I was under the block. I Again, it's one of those slow motion life moments where you can't actually do anything to correct it. I really don't want to give this up, but time is running out. Time is running out. I've not drunk my beer yet. That was a right input there. That wasn't there. That was right. Makes me sad because we are so tantalizingly close. But so time is getting on. We've been on this for, must be about 2 hours 40 now in total, with all the failed first screen attempts that aren't included in the current timer. Thank you. quite mad. I'm just, I think I'm almost like zoning out of the soundtrack right now, and I'm really sort of focusing on listening to like the actual sound effects. It's mad. Sound effects to me are like really prominent for some reason, I don't know why. Maybe after nearly 3 hours of the Celeste B-side summit, you just stop paying too much attention to the music. Higher pitched dash sound. No. Didn't do it upwards. Good recovery. Didn't jump off the cloud. Oh my god. I need to do an up and then an upwards right at that bit. Headset's beeping at me. It's about to die. Saying enough, Nock, I can't take no more tonight. Alright, we played to 2:30 game time, and then that's it for tonight. Yeah, I think if I'm honest, it's better progress than what I was expecting. I was... The horror stories I'd heard about this, I was expecting a lot worse, but I think I've done pretty well. I'm pretty happy with the progress. I just think it's probably a good point now where it's getting late in the night, I'm starting to get tired. Maybe coming back with a clean head. Nice and refreshed tomorrow night. Will do us the world of good. We had a couple of scenarios so far in the playthrough where kind of left the stream at a difficult bit, come back and smashed it within sort of 10-15 minutes of coming back to it. So, yeah, who knows? But I say I'm really happy with the progress that I've made. You know, probably about 7 out of 10 times now I'm getting to that cloud right before the final gem section, so pretty pleased with that. Pretty pleased indeed. So I just love doing this section though. It's something about it just feels so nice when you're putting all these spring sections together. Alright, last one. Last attempt of the night. Alright guys, well, we'll save and quit there. Thank you very much everybody for sticking with it. We are getting there. I just need to, I feel like I'm dashing too late. So what that means is I'm dashing too late. I'm not getting enough height through that gap, which means I drop and then I hit the spikes. So... No, I'm getting all bunged up. But I do know at least I have been through there. Once we get through there, it's a double dash right, double dash up, and a diagonal right. And then there's a few more gems to go. But hopefully tomorrow will be the day. Thank you very much, everybody, though, for tuning in. I appreciate the support as always. Back tomorrow, hopefully finishing Summit, moving on to Core, the final level. But until then, I've been Nock. You've been awesome. See ya.